Hello, Belle.
Bonjour, Gaston. Gaston, may I have my book, please?
How can you read this? There's no pictures.
Well, some people use their imagination.
Belle, it's about time you got your head out of those books and paid attention to more important things. Like me. The whole town's talking about it. It's not right for a woman to read. Soon she starts getting ideas and thinking.
Gaston, you are positively primeval.
Why, thank you, Belle. What do you say you and me take a walk over to the tavern and take a look at my trophies?
Maybe some other time.
What's wrong with her?
She's crazy.
He's gorgeous.
Please, Gaston, I can't. I have to get home to help my father. Goodbye.
That crazy old loon, he needs all the help he can get.
Don't talk about my father that way.
Yeah, don't talk about her father that way.
My father is not crazy. He's a genius. Papa?
How on earth did that happen?
Are you all right, Papa?
I'm about ready to give up in this hunkin' junk.
You always say that.
I mean it this time. I'll never get this boneheaded contraption to work.
Yes, you will. And you'll win first prize at the fair tomorrow. And become a world-famous inventor.
You really believe that?
I always have.
Well, what are we waiting for? I'll have this thing fixed in no time. Hand me that dog-legged clincher there. So, did you have a good time in town today?
I got a new book. Papa, do you think I'm odd?
My daughter? Odd? Where would you get an idea like that?
Oh, I don't know. It's just that I'm not sure I fit in here. There's no one I can really talk to.
What about that Gaston? He's a handsome fella.
He's handsome, all right. And rude and conceited and... Oh, Papa, he's not for me.
Well, don't you worry, because this invention's gonna be the start of a new life for us. I think that's done it. Now, let's give it a try.
You did it!
Hitch up, sleep girl! I'm off to the fair!
Goodbye, Papa! Good luck!
Goodbye, Belle! And take care while I'm gone!